I know we talked about the pimp before, man, but
yeah.
Man, give me a good memory of you kicking it with the pimp, man.
Memory with the pimp, man. Shit, when I recording with him, going to his house, and now, like I say, the night we was there, me, him, Bun B, Juicy J, forgot who I was there, but I know he was talking to Gangsta B on the, well, not DJ Powell, one of the, no disrespect, Powell, you know what I'm talking about. Yeah, but, shit, the night we was there, man, it was, even the first day I met Buddy, man, it was cool, man. I'd explain this shit, bro. When you have like two alpha males around each other, two people who standing on business in the room, and it's crazy because my nigga uptight, man. I was telling him I was gonna have you to come up here. Like I was telling everybody, that's who the whole little old situation was for uptight. Uptight was supposed to have been doing the song. When they got in, the Uptight, more of a Nas-like lyricist type.
Uptight was doing a song with Pimp?
Yeah, that's why he was here, to do the song. That's why the all shit was together.
Mm-hmm.
The whole story. I'm finna tell the story like this because from listening, like, you made me think about a lot of shit, and this is what was going on. I'm not gonna put no names on one part of this shit, but, bro, I didn't even realize when I first met Pimp to do the song, all this shit, I didn't know it was somebody in his ear telling him, Nah, fuck that nigga, bro. Nah, don't do it with him. Fuck with me instead, type shit. Or, you know, I was one, I'm like, who is feeding this man bad shit? But we were still kicking. We were still cool, though. Because the nigga was trying to get me to get away from who I was dealing with. You know, when we got to his house, when we got to Atlanta, Mama West, she had paid for us to come down there to finish the business. Like, this was all good business, bro. So, when we got down there, shit, it was all love. I was like, damn. I started feeling like I was a part of this rap shit a little more. I had did the shit with, Dazz and Corrupt and them, Two Shutting them and shit. But right here, I was like, nigga, this is at home. Because my partner, they wanted to do the California shit. I was on some, let's do the South shit.
South, right.
So when it came up and they called me, and they were like, bro, I want you to come down here, man. I got Pimp down here. I want you to come do something.
Man, and that's like one of the best groups you could have worked with.
Right. Nigga, I was honored, not no bad shit. But when I got there, it's like, nigga, I come to do this shit, whatever. You know, it was love, everything was cool. But you know how you could tell it was some shit going on before you got here? It's some little bullshit. But, man, it was a good memory just to be there, just to listen, just to, you know, just to, you know, to work shit, just to work with homie, man. He a kindred spirit, man. He got a beautiful soul, man. He got a strong mind, too.
How was it seeing him and Bun work together and they interact with each other, man? You know, was they like brothers?
I almost said this minutes ago. I'm gonna put this out there. They was cool. They was like that. I seen love, but when they was in there for that song, they got Looking for the Chewing, man. They recorded this song that night. Matter of fact, y'all can go listen to DJ Paul when he do the talk about the night he was there with Pimp C, go Google it. He tell you this same night. But see, I wasn't nobody with no big name or nothing. So the niggas tell the story, like I keep telling bro, they tell these stories and they always leave me out the story. I'm just the Texas nigga in the room, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But that's cool. I ain't got no problem with that because I didn't give me a chance to tell my own story. But we was in the room, man. He was over there doing the beat for the song. And I guess we was talking and we was kind of loud or something, man. Pimp was like, man, y'all shut the fuck up or some shit. And Bun was like, y'all chill out. And I was like, bro, man, who the fuck he talking to? Bun was like, bro, chill, man. He was like, man, you niggas, like, y'all niggas is, like, damn, like, y'all got the same kind of personality. Y'all gonna bump heads type shit. But to me, I'm just being me from all those guys. But, okay, I said I was hungry. I said, damn, man, we've been here for a while. I'm hungry, the motherfucker. So Pimp, I guess he was hungry too. He was like, well, shit, come on, little homie, shit, we can go up there and get something to eat. We was at the bottom in the basement part, I guess, where you come in through the bottom of the house. It was a big old ass house in Alpharetta, Georgia. Too short, stayed around the corner. But, nigga, when we go to the kitchen, when we go to the kitchen, No, he hollered at me, man. That's why I wish Pimp was still alive, man, so he could vouch for this shit, man. Nigga be thinking a nigga lying and shit. And a nigga can't go ask these rap niggas nothing about me because I never wasn't in the rap game like that. An untrained ear can't hear me, man. A trained ear gonna hear what I'm telling them. I was a street nigga that could rap, bro. My partner and them called me and I was willing to do this shit. They were trying to tell me, leave the streets alone, bro. We gonna turn you on to this rap shit. That was the whole plan. They were trying to show me how this game go.
Mm-hmm.
So, he was up there. He was like, man, so you signed with them or something with old boy now? I was like, nah. They're like, man, management or whatever. He was like, man, come fuck with me. But I kind of, you know, I was researching and, you know, I was with these niggas. And I heard them talking about, you know, the situation with Jive, you know, how they stuff was or whatever. So I was kind of like laughing and shit, like, nigga, sign with your fuck with you. Like, what? You? It was some funny shit to me. But when I tell the story, people might be like, oh, you was, nah, nigga, he was like, we was laughing too. It was some funny shit or whatever. So, man, I know we went back down our shit. We worked, we recorded, him and Bun recorded shit. It was love and some real shit. And you heard it on my interview when I got my homie talking about the shit. Nigga, everything I said that night when I was talking to them niggas, this is how cool everybody was. Even after the nigga shut the fuck up shit. Man, we laughed this shit out. I guess when you say that kind of shit, people be looking for like a beef or friction. Nah, nigga, it became a joke. We started laughing about the shit. We went and got something to eat. We come back, bro. We working. Everybody cool. Everything is all right. So from what I know, the problems have been solved. Mm-hmm. But a lot of people don't know this because I keep telling you, it's somebody reaching out to this man, telling this man bad. He wanted to kind of size me up bad, but he getting me meeting me for himself. Right. So somebody caught when we got there to the man Pimp, we got the Pimp house, bro. When we got to we first flew in. Nigga, we go to his house and we at the back door. Nigga Pimp turned around and say, yeah, we at the back door, nigga Pimp turned around, he was like, Bo man, if anything happened, no, to me or my house, anything, bro. I already know who he is. You from the Grove? I was like, come on, Pimp, man. That conversation ain't for me and you. Like, who are you talking to? And I could never put this together for years, Zeke.
Mm-hmm.
Listen to me, Zeke. I could put this together for years, Zeke. But from our interactions, I bet you could put it together.
So you and Pimp walking into his house and that in Georgia.
All of us, me, him, my partner, Smooth D, now
in a group.
Yeah, we walking up to it was an ice storm. It was real icy. They got them driveways. You know, you gotta go up. So we going up there. It's kind of icy and shit. We get to the back door. The back door had already been kicked in.
Uh huh.
So we walking up. I'm beside him talking. When I look at the door. You know, I kind of step back. I'm thinking like some street trap shit, nigga. Somebody in this house waiting on us or something. So I stopped, but he went ahead and went. So that's how I knew he already knew the door was already like that. It wasn't no, damn, bro. What? But when he going through the door, he's saying this. He's still outside. He reaching for the door. He making this little comment. So now I'm still playing cool, but I'm thinking in my mind, man, which one of these niggas in Dallas is hating? Like, who got a problem with me doing business with this man?
Because
he been paid. But it's somebody instead of trying to stop the business. I'm like, but it was weird because, okay, Clint Black was there. Goddamn me, DJ Snake was there. Snake, matter of fact, we went to Snake house, man, to chill. Scarface came through there, asked Clint and them, nigga, I dropped a hot 16 on face, nigga. And ain't too many niggas that never did that in their life, nigga, and got a standing ovation. That's a whole nother story we're going to talk about because the verse I gave him, man, we don't leave that alone, man.
Yeah. So you was doing good music with a lot of little artists.
Yeah, I was doing a lot of good shit, bro. I was in position.
Did you ever find out who was hating on you?
Nah, I kind of know.
You kind of had
I kind of got an idea. But if I would have, like, if the shit would have came to me at a later date, I probably would have been upset about it. But like, man, I'm grown now. Life good, Jack. You know what I'm saying? That I ain't tripping because I don't give a fuck about no rap now. But when I was trying to do my rap thing, it's crazy because some of these same people, they'll be saying how they got love for the city, how they want to put people on, and it'll be somebody you ain't never did nothing wrong to. And yeah. you're like, why? But they'll get in front of the camera and say, man, we tried to promote everybody. We tried to help everybody. Because they think people don't know. But it's just how it is, man. And yeah. I ain't going to say no name because I ain't going to give them no clout like that. I'm going to give them a chance. How they say, right. shame the devil. I'm going to give them a chance to come out and speak on it on themselves because it all makes sense today because when you sit back and you look, and you're like, damn, there was so much going on. And then I'm gonna throw this in there. I seen these two individuals pimping this person after the club one night before I went to jail. And when I was walking up on them, I knew something had happened because it wasn't that pimp wasn't acting like pimp with me.
Right.
He was standoffish. Then they was looking like they thought, man, niggas with me was finna do something.
He was riding the middle of the fence. He had to choose sides.
Right. So when I seen him, I kind of seen what it was. We walking out the club, nigga, the spy club. And we walking to the back parking lot. I see him. I'm thinking, hey, man, there go my guy. There go pimp. You know, I'm lost to the whole thing, the bullshit, everything, because ain't nobody told me about no bullshit. I'm thinking everything is still cool, sweet. But that's the first thing. The niggas that was with me, my witnesses, of who was there and what happened. They was like, damn, nigga, what's up with them, bro? Y'all into it or something? I'm like, nigga, I'm confused because I thought it was all love, daddy. Mm. But now, that's why I thought, matter of fact, bro, I reached out and tried to talk and holler at a motherfucker about a situation and they act like everything was cool. Mm. But I guess it's not. And I don't know why, bro. I don't even get it. But I put it like this. I'm going to tell the truth, bro. And I feel like a lot of this shit, even with Pimp, bro, Pimp deserve his respect. Jay Prince deserve his respect. Even with my partner Ron, bro, all of them deserve their respect, right. bro. And I'm going to keep saying this
shit. For the people that don't know,
go ahead.
During the time you and your crew right. relationship with Pimp and UGK,
right.
y'all had some differences.
Yeah, right. some differences, yeah. Cause
right, Pimp, so some people might say in the song when he say, I went to Dallas and some niggas tried to take me.
That's the truth.
He was talking about you that's and your crew.
That's what we talking about. Yes, he was talking about my nigga Ron. He talking about when the yellow hoe trying to sound like an OG and all that shit.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, that's what we were talking about. Uncle Paul talking was about to break you off, all this shit.
Yeah.
Yes, he's telling the truth. All this shit he talking about, it happened. It might didn't happen the exact way he said it happened. I'm going to tell you this on some real shit. When that nigga say he seen a square body Benz, all this bullshit was driving kind of funny, all that. Mm. Man, that nigga must have been high, man, because wasn't nobody around, wasn't nobody bothered them. Because there wasn't no beef like that. They got to understand. Yeah. They fucking with niggas who...
Okay, I remember somebody had said that it was a hit out on Pimp C.
Okay.
And you called me immediately,
Let's clear this shit up. About when a nigga say they was at the club and there was a nigga walking around with a trench coat and a 10-gallon hat, all this shit.
Right.
You know who that was?
Uh-huh.
When who hires a hitman in a fucking trench coat and a 10-gallon hat? We got a club full of niggas that are killed.
Uh-huh.
Why we going to send some, go get some stranger, put them in our, no. That was a nigga coming to serve them because they was being sued. If I'm lying, I'm dying. These are facts. For real. It was the man was trying to, because he came to everybody
right.
looking for them. This might be that same night when I seen them leaving. But watch this, bro. And I was like, I'm thinking so maybe. You know how you hear people talking and you realize they couldn't have been there.
Mm-hmm.
They got to be getting this shit secondhand. Because the people who was really there, you know what I'm saying? I know I'm doing some shit that's unpopular. I'm going to be the underdog for speaking on this kind of shit. But hey, man, Jay Prince Sr. can tell y'all, if anybody ever interview him and speak on this shit, a bum be or any of them niggas about the situation, them same niggas that Pimp was talking about. When Pimp did the motherfucking song with Big Pippin with Jay-Z, niggas ain't knowing them same niggas on the video shoot. When Pimp C got out of jail, said, nigga can't tell you all this shit because Pimp wasn't fucking with a lot of people when he got out.
Mm-hmm.
But Pimp straightened these guys out like a man.
You talking about the guys in your crew?
The guys in my crew. The guys right. who we owed the money from the business we was doing that we didn't get to finish.
Right.
Hey, man. So. Pimp, like a man, reached out. I just talked to my nigga too, but he said he was on his way to therapy.
All that beef was squashed.
It was squashed. It was dead. So when I'm hearing somebody, that was my whole thing. People think I'm trying to start something, bro. How are you trying to start trouble if you're just trying to correct an incorrect story. That's all. I don't want nobody thinking Pimp had a beef with niggas out of Dallas. No, he had a Pimp that had situations with a lot of niggas, but people ain't telling you these same niggas who he had this situation with been fucking with him since Riding Dirty, man. Mm-hmm. Since Too Hard to Swallow. Since his first album, come to Dallas doing shows. These ain't no niggas that he just met. Everybody is cool. Nigga, I just told y'all, nigga paid his mama the money. Mama West. So that mean a nigga really know these people, man. I know, but not me, per se, but my partner and them, Smooth D, niggas I'm dealing with and Run, man, RIP. They really know these people, so they dealing with them. I told people how I came into the picture. Nigga ain't never heard me say I was no rapper or none of this shit, even though I could out-rap half the motherfucking rappers. The mm-hmm. problem with me with the rap shit was I could never figure out how we gonna separate mine from theirs. And that's my honest to God shit. I couldn't figure out how we gonna separate mine from yours, so I found some shit that was working for me. Bro, I need the story corrected, bro. My partner did not put no motherfucking hit out on Pimp C. That shit is a lie.
That was never a hit.
Why would it be? You don't already paid. I want to meet this hit man that they say went to go talk to Jay Prince.
The story come from, what was the, Beverly something?
What? Look the book up online and buy it right now. My partner Smooth D, he put a cease and desist on the book.
Who do you think her source was?
I don't know. Whoever her source was, I need to holler at them. Because it was a lot of incorrect stuff. And then, man, y'all done came and slandered a man's name. This man's family got his kids and shit. Y'all putting this out. I'm talking about then some of the people claim that they friends with him. That's not honoring a friend, bro. You supposed to straighten that shit out and be like, mm-hmm. yeah, them niggas had a situation. They put the song out. Like the same way we laughed that night there about the little shit up shit. The song was laughed about. That's Pimp. What else is he going to do besides write a song about you, man?
Was it more Pimp and less Bun? Or it was both.
It was more Pimp. It was more Pimp. The whole business was with Pimp. Mm-hmm. It was the whole situation was with Pimp. When I first got there and I showed up, it was Pimp and I forgot the goddamn. I know the guy who was manager at the time.
Wow.
At the kitchen, the same studio you talking about at the kitchen.
It was a rumor that Jay Prince paid for his ransom or something.
Yeah, talking about Jay.
Is it? That's false, too?
It wasn't no ransom or nothing like that, bro. I didn't want to put all this out there because I be doing this shit, but I don't want to be no celebrity, nothing like that, man. I like my quiet life, but watch this. My nigga, me, and my nigga Smooth and Run, we went to Houston mm-hmm. to go meet with Lil J. It wasn't no gaffling no nigga, handling no nigga up, none of this. No. He was like, hey, man, I know some of y'all people. I know y'all good guys. Hey, man, let's talk about what's going on. Nigga went down there and met with them. If I'm lying, I'm dying. Jay Prince can tell you. Don't tell you what I seen because I wasn't in the car that pulled up on them. I get them this, though.
You saying there wasn't never no gangster shit?
Not no gang, but this is a true story. I wish I could call Smooth right now. But these niggas know who Smooth D was. DJ at the club, Brain, Mary J, and them, everybody down here work for MCA Records, all this shit. My nigga. Nigga went to Houston. I can't remember what street it was. They had a nigga to pull up on the street, pull in behind them. Mm-hmm. But I can say that this was the most gangster shit they did about it. When a nigga pulled on the street, see, wasn't nobody anticipating that. But I wasn't in the same car, though, because I didn't know how the shit was going to go. Mm-hmm. Everybody else was named nameless. Mm-hmm. A nigga wasn't going for no trouble with Rap-A-Lot and them now, but I was like, I don't know how this shit gonna go. If it is gonna be some shit, they ain't finna just get out with some of them gotta go too. But a nigga went down, that nigga, my partner, wouldn't even shake Jay Prince's hand, man. He was trying to shake Ron's hand. Ron wouldn't even shake his hand. Well, Ron just wanted his money, man. Y'all done play with me long enough. And that's all it was.
So the ransom money they speaking on, that's really him paying the money they owe.
It wasn't no ransom money, bro. That shit about a hit. Who is the hit man? I keep telling y'all. Who is this hit man that got the word and he went and told Jay Prince? And Jay Prince like, nah, you can't do that. So he called them. No. I wish Mama West was still alive. I kept telling you what the common denominator was. The money was paid to Mama West. Mama West telling Pimp, hey, man, I got these guys' money. You know, go ahead and knock this out. Finish it. Pimp was doing the shit with no problem. But after a while, He ended up getting some more money out of us. But it was like, I think he started saying, man,
y'all did
that other business. Money. He probably didn't get the other money, so.
I heard you on a, on a, I don't know if that was a video you was showing me or in one of my interviews. You was like, Pimp came to the motel in an ice storm.
Yeah, he came to the ice storm to get some money. He didn't call my partner and them.
It was kind of funny. He was like, man, he ran back to
the bank. Yeah, he kind of threw us off because I was like, he was my rest cooler in peace, with them. Pimp, man. Yeah, rest in peace, Pimp. This is not no slander shit. Don't let nobody think it is, because it was, I'm telling you, it was all love. It wasn't no shit. If we wouldn't, the nigga called my phone. He was like, saying something about the ice storm. The lights had went out at the house. That's where we had been recording it. Mm-hmm. He was like, he need to, rearrange, I guess, get us another spot to record and put his family up in the room. I ain't saying he was broke, but I guess he felt like, shit, y'all gonna give me some more money, so why not get it from there? But when he came and got the money, I told him, I was like, yeah, it's cool, yeah, look, nigga, whatever. I think Smooth gave him the money. When they gave him the money, I'm coming out the bathroom, and I heard a footsteps from me in the bathroom. You can hear the hallway. I didn't hear him leaving, but I heard some feet, boom, 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 running.
Patting and turning.
I'm like, what the fuck this nigga running for? So I walk over to the window. Some told me, let's look out the window and see what's going on. But I seen a van out there. It looked small, like an Astro van or something. It was a nigga standing out there at the door of the van, holding the door of the van, waiting for Pimp. Pimp ran, he jumped in the back of the van, and the nigga got in, they closed the door, and they burnt off. And I was telling my partner now, man, what the fuck just happened? What? He act like he just robbed somebody or something.
The nigga had the door waiting
on him like it was a robbery, but nigga, you on the fifth floor or some shit. You had to go catch the elevator, go there. I say, is he making them think he just came and took something? I don't know what it was, bro. The shit was weird.
That fucked you up,
bro. But I seen niggas got a problem with my partner saying, Pimp reached out, he told him, he got out, hey, bro, I was tripping, man. You know them, bro, drugs a motherfucker. I'm not saying that to disrespect homie and be like, man, he was a drug addict.
No, that's what drugs. I was going to ask you, man. By the all the time you hung out with Pimp and kicked it with him, you know, they ruled his death as an overdose of drugs. Do you think that was
at the Mondrian Hotel?
Do you think that was the cause of his death, or do you think it was foul play involved?
I ain't gonna even. I think if it was foul play, the way the Mondrian Hotel set up, I can't see nobody doing nothing and getting up out of there like that. The cameras, like, I told nigga a story about nigga. We came back from after the night that. When Big U, little brother, got killed, that shit at the studio when that shit happened. Echo Sound. Nigga, when I left from there, we went back to the room at the same hotel, the Mondrian Hotel on Sunset. It's something about this hotel. I run into all the Texas motherfuckers when I'm down there. So when Pimp was there, I was like, damn, Pimp staying over there. And I'm like, damn, it's high security. Ain't no everybody ain't walking in up out of there. You know what I'm saying? They got cameras and at night that shit happened. Nigga, I was finna leave because I thought the FBI was watching the hotel. Nigga, I kept on seeing so much shit. Motherfucker with earpieces and Jerry Springer was staying on the hallway with us. Like, so I'm like, oh, this is some upper class shit. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I put it like this. If somebody did do something and they got away from that motherfucker, they look professional, bro. Like, if it was foul play, I heard one theory of they saying it was a female probably was in there with him. And what if she did something to him and it was supposed to be blood? I heard Pimp and Ken say something on it, and I heard a few different people, you know, different theories, but I don't know, man. It's hard for me to say somebody did.